You're listening to the very 23rd episode of the Celtic Crack Podcast.
I missed your intros, Mikey. They were a lot funnier.
They were, yeah. Times were better back when Mikey used to do an intro.
Oh, well.
I loved the new intro on that, but you could always do a funny intro and then play the music.
Yeah. Could, yeah.
That's what I said. Like, I had that written down here as one of my topics to bring up last week.
Oh, no, did you
and
know,
I just,
yeah.
I wrote it. I did, yeah, and I brought it up. And I had it written here in my notes as No More Mikey. Just so I'd remember, oh yeah, No More Mikey doing intros, blah, blah. Mikey didn't saw it and got all insulted. He was like, looking at my notes, he was like, No More Mikey? What you mean, No More Mikey? He thought I was going to replace him.
I thought it was you said No More Mickey.
Oh yeah, I'm not taking No More Mickey either.
No.
All
right.
Not taking any less though either.
Yeah. Lads, I'm going to have to start reading your notes before we start.
Proofread all,
yeah.
Everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Nah,
yeah.
If that happened, there'd be no show.
Imagine someone
was going through all our notes. Like,
You can't do that.
Imagine that's what happens. No one, like, you know, RTE and fucking all these proper legit shows like that are going to be on TV and the radio.
Doesn't happen on Channel 4 though, man. Anything fucking goes. Channel 4 like, or E4, anything goes in that past.
I was only thinking of that recently. If you watch Celebrity Juice, the fucking shit they're talking about on there, and that's on telly. Like,
even Catch Those Countdown, man, as well. Like, yeah. You know what I mean?
Celebrity Juice is probably the worst though, man.
Yeah, yeah.
The shit they come up with.
I don't like it anymore though, man.
The games they played on all, to bring on celebrities and make them play these mad games, they're licking each other and fucking doing all sick shit like.
Yeah, that's why I don't like it, man. It's disgusting. It turns my stomach.
Like, I've often said things on here and, or one of us has said something and we'd be like, I'd be thinking like, is that a bit too far? Like, you know, should we be saying shit like that? Then you watch Celebrity Juice and you're like, we are tame.
Yeah.
We need to fucking put the foot down a bit now and fucking.
If it's good enough for Keith Lemon, it's good enough for me.
Yeah. Keith Lemon's a bit of a ledge.
I don't agree with you, though. He is getting a bit played out.
Yeah,
he
is. He's trying a bit too hard. Like,
I don't know.
But all that shit, all those disgusting games, I don't like, man. I mean, I love the old comedy when he takes the piss out of Fern Cotton. I think it's brilliant.
Yeah, he's brilliant.
But when he goes away and there's a game, then, and it kind of turns my stomach. I'm like, I'll turn it off straight away. I won't watch it anymore. You know,
no.
And that's it. No, it's done. I can't handle that shit, man.
Bruh, I mean, you changed.
I did change, man.
Do you know what it was on last night? I think it was. I think it was.
On to the next topic.
No, I think it was an old repeat last night or whatever. They're kind of showing all the Halloween ones. And Holly Willoughby was on it, dressed as Harley Quinn. Have you seen that one?
Seen that one, yeah.
My God.
Holly Willoughby. I was only talking to one of the boys in work.
I respect her so much as a female professional.
Yeah. She's fantastic.
I'm saying, like,
breasts.
I'm just saying, like, that's all I'm saying. I respect her so much for what she's achieved in her career.
Yeah. For two reasons alone.
A lot more than two reasons.
Two big reasons.
That's how she started out as a bra model, like.
No way.
Do you remember that ad? It said, hello, boys, or something like that. And
would you like to buy a bra, boys? Is it a bra advert mainly targeted for young fellas?
Who was she talking to?
For holding Kens.
Bring a Kens into the Energizer disco. One for Nagin, one for a Ken.
Big bra Kens with the lads. What the fuck? How is it I've never seen these pictures? Send pics, Mikey.
two liters of Linda Village.
For fuck's sake. Which, she's very good. She's very professional. Oh, Mikey's gone looking her up now.
It's all right. You don't need to bring the nagging when you bring a woman.
Throw it and drink hers.
Because women do all the nagging. Is that what you're saying?
Oh, man.
No.
It is.
No, don't try to backpedal now.
And you claim to be a feminist.
Yeah. Calling himself. He spent the last 20 minutes before the episode started now talking about how he was such a big feminist. Yeah. And then he starts with that.
Oh, but how much he respects Sinead O'Connor. Come on, the fuck.
Jude is just mad talking about Sinead O'Connor.
Nothing compares to her. Nothing compares to her, no.
Yeah. Oh, there she is now. Hello, boys.
That's what made her famous.
Oh, hello, Holly. Oh. 20 years of cleavage.
What?
Yurt.
Yeah. She has hot stuff.
Horror. Do you know who else is?
And she seems like serious crack too.
Do you know who else is unreal as well as that? Amanda Holden, man.
Amanda Holden. Ah, no.
Yeah,
you're
man.
You're one from that Britain's fucking one of those
talent,
ones,
man.
Yeah?
I think she's tasty bird, man.
She is, even for her age.
Yeah. She's 50, like.
Yeah. She's fake, bro.
Or has fucking...
fake
or has,
face, bro.
Or has, yeah. What's the name, Frankie Boyle sister? She looks like Haunted Topo.
Yeah.
Where did you get that comparison out of? Like, but now that he said it, I'm like, yeah, she kind of does.
Even though you've never seen Haunted Topo, where, like...
Well, just, I've a melted lid at home, man. She looks fairly like it now.
No, I hate that look, man, when their face is all frozen and plasticky looking. Not a fan.
But you know who is? You know who is some fucking borders? Was that Elizabeth Hurley, man, for her age as well?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
And her brother Johnny Gaelic football.
That's not all she is, though. She's also very good at other stuff, like. Yeah.
What's acting. The one that was in Friends?
Jennifer Aniston?
Yeah, she outdoes them all.
She does, yeah. And that's exactly what I said to your man the other day when I was having a conversation about all these MILFs. She's like, no, none will talk. And he was like, what the fuck was that pleb thinking, fucking Brad Pitt going for fucking Angelina Jolie? She's like a pair of lips on a stick.
She was hot.
She was back in her 20s, man.
Yeah.
There's something wrong with that comment. For one, he is no pleb, I know, I tell you that. If I had his money.
Nah, but
we're not about choice of women, though. We're not on about money, like.
He's Brad Pitt, man. He's just going to do whatever the fuck he wants at the end of the day, I would say. Yeah.
I hate to be that guy, but I have a slight technical problem here.
What's that?
The monitor isn't coming up on.
Oh. 1 second.
We'll be back after these messages.
Are we back?
We're back.
We're back. Had a bit of a. Mikey, 3 screens, was nearly down to 2 screens.
Yeah. He got demoted like there for a second, didn't he?
That was you slagging, saying he was getting demoted a while ago.
Yeah, probably, see? Yeah. Jinxed us.
Yeah.
Power of the mind, boys. Power of the mind.
Jesus, if you're mounted.
Unagi.
Speaking of Unagi.
Aragami.
Unagi, robbing cans in Blackpool.
Oh, he was, yeah. Robbing a big bag of cans for the lads. Yeah. Snake.
Remember,
man.
It's bag of cans, not bag of cans.
Yeah.
Remember that?
He has a can-do attitude. He has a full slab of can-do attitude.
He robbed Dutch
gold.
Yeah. Did you see that story?
No.
He was there was some fella like that looked exactly like him. Well, looked very like him. Was caught on CCTV robbing like a slab of cans out of an off license or something, was that?
In Blackpool, England.
So people were posting it online saying like, is this David Schwimmer or whatever?
He does look like him.
He does. There's Ross then like retaliated. He was like,
Ross.
Ross again, yeah. As you can see, I was in Blackpool, but I hope you catch him. All the best to the Blackpool police. And it was just him walking through like fucking the aisle with a bag of slab. That's it there, yeah.
He was busy robbing cans in America, so he couldn't have been robbing cans in Liverpool.
Blackpool.
What's
that word? Parallel universes happening there, was it?
It's a glitch in the matrix. See, why is it told you like?
Fucked up, man.
You think I'm mad?
He is the head off him, doesn't he?
He looks more kind of Indian or something. I saw
as well that a woman put up that she reckons it's her son that went missing a couple of years ago. Did you not see that? No?
Ah, stop.
Yeah. She put up a photograph then of her son and there was some similarities there. Like he went missing like 11 or 12 years ago or something.
Weird. Imagine if that's how you found him, like Robin Kent.
Robin Kent. And she got onto the police then straight away, like, knowing he's going to get locked up, but at least she'll have her son back.
Yeah, she'll know where to visit him then. Like,
yeah, yeah.
At the moment, she doesn't know where to visit him, so visit him in the HMP. Isn't that what they call it over there?
Her Majesty's pleasure.
Her Majesty's prison. Her Majesty's
pleasure. Yeah.
So we're going to have to change everything now over feminists.
Well, no, look, this is the thing now, lads. The world has just gone PC mad. This is PC gone mad now. This is just, I see this shit all the time. Kleenex, forced to change name of man-sized facial tissues. Facial tissues.
As opposed to arsenal tissues.
I'll start again. Kleenex forced to change name of man-sized facial tissues after sexism complaints. Now, so Kleenex have been sexist all along by referring to their tissues as man-sized.
They don't have any
woman-sized ones. No, it's not fair. Or maybe you should just... Why do they have to put a gender on it? Why don't you just call it person size or adult size? Standard human size.
Feminists are only opening... They're only opening the door for themselves to get a fucking piss take. Do you know what I mean?
I wouldn't say feminists, no. I would say feminazis.
Feminazis, I suppose. No,
feminists are okay.
Yeah.
Do you know what Kleenex should have done? They should have said, if you have an issue... Here's a man-sized tissue.
serious slogan, man, for a new campaign from him.
I'd like to see a company just stand up and say, fuck off, you sad bastards. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
This is my company. I call it what I like.
If you don't want to buy it, don't fucking buy it then, yeah?
Don't have snotty noses.
Use your hand to wipe your fucking
stop
face.
Giving blowjobs as well.
But we made them for you. They're facial tissues for every time you take get a facial, you dirty bitch.
Well, they're all used for cum. You all know that, I know.
I know, yeah.
And they are for men anyway. Men use them for a personal reason.
My mother watches this show, man.
Does she? So now she knows what you used to be up to with all the Kleenex in the room.
Hi, no Kleenexes, boys. Socks all the way, okay?
Oh, man.
They stand up by themselves.
Crusty socks. Yeah, that's madness. Like, I've seen a few things like this now during the week. I saw another one a while ago where it was... Aldi, I think it was, is coming under fire. You know, these fucking stupid headlines they come out with because of gender-biased parking signs. Do you know they have those mother and baby parking spots outside?
Myself and my mother always use them. Like, men know. They don't put an age limit on it.
Yeah, but like men are giving out. The men are at it now as well. Like, what about the father and baby?
I think they're only doing it to take the piss, though.
I hope so. But either way, like,
what is it?
Fucking find something else to do.
Probably deadbeat's dad. Dad's doing it. Just say, look, I take my child.
Yeah, what, a big do you want a cookie? Always looking for credit for some shit you're just supposed to do.
Yeah, I know.
I take care of my kids.
Yeah, I pay my bills. Good. I do my shopping in Aldi.
What, do you want a cookie?
Always looking for some credit for some shit they're just supposed to do.
Accept things.
Oh, what's this, Mikey? PC too after
many,
PC.
See, there's too many snowflakes, man. And people are paying attention to them. That's the worst part. Like, I'd love to see someone complain to me about something I said on this podcast. They'll just be told where to go, like.
Go fuck yourself. If you don't like it, don't watch it. Yeah, if it offends you, you have the option to fucking not watch it.
Exactly. And
please tell your friends about it, though, because we need viewers.
As I said a while ago, I'm all for equal rights, but I'm all for free speech, too.
Stop tapping the table.
You know,
You're all for tapping tables.
All for tapping other things as well.
I don't know, man. Like, just paying attention to these sad little bastards sitting at home. Just like most of the stuff they're complaining about, I'm convinced they don't really give a fuck. They just want to see how far they can go with it. See if they can get someone sacked or see if they can get them to change the name. Draw. Feel like they accomplished something then because they're doing fuck all else with themselves.
We're at home then fucking robbing their 9 cats. Oh, we did it, love. We did it, Popsy. We did it, Snowflake.
Here's an idea. Go away and get a job or get a hobby or something.
I'll get a man.
And then you might feel like you've done something at the end of the week.
Get a rabbit.
Get fucking something, rabbit. Man. Fucking ridiculous, like. Here's another one, another example of it. The Simpsons set to drop Apu altogether.
What have they been doing all along? The
Simpsons are dropping Apu. So they're getting rid of fucking Apu's character following racism controversy.
Negative stereotype.
So Apu now is a
negative
stereotype.
Tell me what's negative about that, though, because the majority of petrol stations around the world are owned by people from that part of the world.
Exactly. Well, think about it. Like,
what's negative
about that? He's an immigrant who moved to America. Now he's a business owner.
Yeah.
Is that negative?
Mm-hmm. No.
Do you know what I mean?
We're talking about him now as if he's a real person.
I know, but this is the character, like.
Yeah.
But like, if that cartoon was all white people, wouldn't people be giving out that
there wasn't any
diversity in it?
Yeah, exactly. Well done, Mikey. Well done.
Yeah.
People need to see your face, man. Ah. You make good points.
I'm the best looking out of the whole lot of you. Yeah.
Prove it. Prove it. Prove it.
You ever seen Fred that guru like guy? What's his name? Tony Robbins.
Tony Robbins. If you've ever wondered what Mikey looks like, just look up Tony Robbins, that self-help guru. That is Mikey. Same height as him and Ollie is. Yeah.
Sure, let's get him up there, Mikey.
Get him up,
have
Michael.
You ever seen him?
No.
Ah, man, you know Tony Robbins, no?
There he is, there, look.
Mikey had that as his profile picture on Facebook for ages.
Did he? Just because I said it to him in Mildura.
Tony Robbins. Do you remember that was a Shallow Hal?
Shallow Hal,
where
yeah.
he meets him
oh,
in the...
Oh, that's right, to be huge for
he was like, can you help me out? And then he kind of hypnotizes him or whatever. That's what Mikey looks like for all of you who are wondering.
Wasn't he in a new episode of Family Guy trying to help Peter?
Tony Robbins?
Yeah.
Probably was.
There he is there, look. Yeah. Shut your mouth, he said. Shut your mouth and listen, you fucking idiot. You're going to be a good child.
Yeah, but should send him on to the feminists. Get them to accept things in their lives and just get on with it.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. He's just going to say what they want to hear.
Look at the size of him though, man. He's some fuck. He's a unit of a man, isn't he?
Mm. Not as big as Mike, you know, like, but he's fairly big,
he's
you know.
Not as big as our Mike, you know.
Nah. Our Mikey's a country boy. He spuds all his life.
In every sense, ladies.
How do you know? Spying on him again.
Hung like a tire.
It's hard to miss it when you're next to him in a urinal, like, you know. So.
Jesus.
I went home feeling very insecure that day, I did.
Yeah. Which another one that I saw actually recently was gingerbread persons. Gingerbread persons for sale.
I love person.
And that word I'm even annoys
about
me,
even ginger.
Persons.
I'm not about the word even ginger. Is that not?
Oh, do you find that offensive?
Intolerance, yeah. I'd like, you know.
Well, that's referring to
me.
Ginger that grows out of the ground.
You don't look like you've red hair, man. I'm just putting it out there. Like, I don't know you since you were a young fella, but to me, you don't look
it
like you're red.
It was a lot redder back in the day, like.
Look, Jude, look.
Oh,
I can nor deny or confirm. he's
shaven down there. But yeah, gingerbread persons introduced now, lads. Do you know what I mean?
For fuck's sake.
Strange times we're living in. I'm telling you, people are paying.
I'm not changing from man. I'd give up bollocks. I'm not changing from.
I'm not a hitter.
No. I am who I am.
Couldn't care less. Like a lot of the shit that we joke about now, like it's all politically incorrect and it's, oh, you shouldn't joke about it. That's why we joke about it. Yeah. Most of it is like just for the shock value of it. Mm. Do you know what I mean? We don't really think it's funny if someone is fucking...
Well, we do if there's a funny side to it. Do
you know what I mean? Yeah, but like most of the time I'm saying we're kind of laughing at the idea of laughing at that thing because it's so ridiculous to make a joke about it, you know? We're not actually really being bad-minded. It's a fucking joke, like. And people then... People know this as well. They see stand-up comedians making jokes about certain things and they want to just make a big deal out of it. Yeah. Even though they know the person's only fucking joking, he's a comedian. Yeah. But they want to try and get him fired and, oh man, it's a weird old thing that's going on these days.
Because of pricks.
I tell you, man, people have nothing better to be doing.
Do you know what wrecks my head as well? Like, we'll take Caitlyn Jenner off, for example. I've no problem calling Caitlyn Jenner, but I'm not going to fucking say it's a woman because it's not a fucking woman, like. Mm. Oh, no, you're born a man.
Cross the line.
No, but if you're born a man, you're born a man. It's as simple as that. If you want to identify as a woman, that's your own business. You know what I mean? But I'm not going to sit here and lie to myself saying that you're a woman when you're not a woman. You're a fucking man. It's plain and simple. It's your own shit luck if you want to be fucking wanted to be born in a different body. And if you were born in a different body, like.
Yeah. He seems to have got caught like, by that before. Just, say, like
he did spend a lot of time in Thailand.
He did, yeah.
But but that fucking Bruce Jenner, man, I couldn't even be bothered calling him Caitlyn. Like, that's how bad I am with him. With anyone else out there, fair enough. Like, there are a lot of genuine cases out there where people are transgender and all that. I 100% believe that you can be born like in the wrong body and feel like you should be a different gender. All of that, fair enough. But for him. And I'm still calling him. I can't even bring myself. Like, I know other transgender people, like, and I've no problem referring to them as
her
what
or
they
him.
Identify as. Yeah. But with him, for some reason, I'm still even calling him. I can't, like.
Because I don't believe it. I think it's a pure cry for attention.
Yeah, I don't believe it. Because, like, he came out and he was like, I'm a woman. I'm going to live my life as a woman. Went away and got all these mad surgeries done, got fake tits, even got his jawline shaved down and his whole skull reshaped to make him look more feminine. Kept his dick and balls.
And said, I'm going to ride women as well.
And then about 6 months after all the hype about him died down, he started releasing statements that I'm thinking about going back to being a man.
Yeah.
Okay. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? Do you know what I mean? Why? Like, I would imagine that if I had this man's body and I felt like I was a woman, that dick between my legs would disgust me. And if I had the money and the means of doing it like he has, why would you not do it? Why would you go and get everything else done and then leave that?
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? Like, if you feel like... You're a fucking woman, but you have a big dick. You have the option to get rid of it, but you choose not to.
How do you know it's big?
Well, talking about myself here, like, do you know what I mean? Do you know? I just don't believe him.
I get you.
I don't believe him, like, I don't know. There's something, I think he's just, man, I think, like, that Ben Shapiro talks about, that, like, it used to be called fucking gender dysphoria. That was the proper name for it, and people would be diagnosed with having a psychological illness if they said that they were, oh, I'm actually a woman, when you're looking at them and they're a man. I think he's more on along those lines where he's just a bit fucked up in the head. I think he just doesn't know what he wants. Like,
he's an attention seeker.
To go through all that and then turn around and say that he was thinking about becoming a man again.
But don't most of them say, even when they were young boys, they even felt like they were a girl?
Yeah.
And then he's coming out, what is he, about 60 years of age?
Probably, yeah.
You know, all of a sudden, I want to be a woman. Now I want to be a man again.
Yeah. I'm keeping my dick. Like, what the fuck? I don't know, man. I just don't get it. Do you know what? What were you going to say there, Jude? Sorry.
No, it's out of my head, no.
You pointed at penguins or something, was it?
Oh, yeah. Paid same-sex penguins raise egg by themselves. I was like, man, you're taking the piss here now.
Gay penguins successfully hatch baby chick and take turns to care for it. Ah, gay penguins. Ah. That's gas, like. How did another gay?
I know, yeah.
Just how the way they waddle, like.
did you just assume their sexual orientation there, did you? Say, like,
keep maybe one fin kind of higher than the other one.
That'd be too flamboyant.
See, this is why you need to be on camera, man, because nobody saw that hand gesture.
Penguin.
Can you recreate it from there?
They can see my shadow behind Stooge's head.
It was like, if you ever suppose do that, I'm a little teapot. That's the kind of gesture Mikey just made.
Short and stout.
Here's my hands and here's my spouse.
Here's my cock.
Put it in your mouth. No, I mean, no, not that. Not that.
Fucking hell, gay penguin.
Yeah, maybe one of those
penguins. That penguin's going to get picked on in school, like, definitely
maybe,
is.
Maybe one of those penguins identifies as female.
Pick on a penguin. Oh, man. Oh, I lined that one up here, didn't I?
Do you did.
Yeah, you got a home run that, with that one as well,
yeah,
you cunt.
You set me up.
I like penguins.
Did you ever see the penguins shitting on the other penguins? Comical.
No.
That's pretty funny.
Do you ever see him shit like this, the shit spreads about 5-6 feet away from the body.
There's one penguin just lying down like that, and another penguin walks past him and just bends over like that and just shits right in his face. See if we get it up, Mikey. It's comical, it's very funny.
I saw a video.
Makes for good TV.
Just to tell you about too much access to information that we have these days. I actually saw a video of, I think it was a walrus or something, raping a penguin.
Yeah, I saw that as well.
Like, what the fuck? I did not need to see that, but I saw it, like, and that memory is in my head now.
Yeah. I think we should do something about it, man. That walrus needs to be fucking stopped.
It's strange times.
Is it a gay walrus?
Who the fuck? Probably, yeah. I don't know.
he looked like a rapist anyway, with the big mustache on him.
Fuck's sake.
Watch the two penguins. Oh, watch, you look lovely, look. Thanks, love.
You're dropping the hand in, look, dropping the fin.
Dropping the fin. Dropping the flipper.
There's the fin flipper. What is it? Fin. Yeah, fin would be wrong, wouldn't it? Dropping the flipper. Penguins, they like, look like they're wearing tuxedos.
Yeah, but they're not actually wearing tuxedos.
I wonder, is that where they got Popper's penguins out of? Because the penguins was doing too much Popper's.
Popper's penguins? I never heard of that. What is that?
Isn't it a weird word, though? Isn't it penguin?
Penguin. I know so many people who call them penguins. It's penguins. Fucking hilarious.
Who do you know does, man? Benedict Cumberbatch.
Yeah.
He does a documentary on penguins, and he kind of gets away with the first time saying it, but then after that, then he loses control, and he just cannot say the word. Penguin. Penguin. He just can't. And he knows he's making a mistake, and he's trying to fucking get it correct, but he just fucks it up even worse each time.
Fuck's sake. Yeah, what was that? Did you find that story, Mikey, about John Cena? Was it even true?
Oh, yeah.
John Cena, apparently, John Cena said to a blind kid, "You can't see me." Like, for fuck's sake. I don't know much about John
Cena.
Like,
the Chinese. Like,
oh, there it is. John Cena tells blind kid, "You can't see me."
Oh, lads.
Did he really, man? I wonder, like. But that's kind of his little trademark thing or something, isn't it? His catchphrase.
He does that.
Where he does this thing with his hand or something. He says, "You can't see me. You can't see me."
He said that to the blanket, and the blanket goes, "I know."
Yeah, obviously.
John Cena waved his signature right hand in front of the 10-year-old Jerry Smith and told him, "You can't see me." Little Jerry was suffering from an optic nerve disorder that rendered him blind.
Did he know, though? We don't know. If he knew. Cringe. You can't see me. He probably didn't even know the child was blind and probably thought, this is going to be brilliant. The child is going to be so happy to see me do my move. Then, like, nope. Child is just...
Wait till you see this kid.
Yeah. Remember McGregor talking about him. That was the first time I heard about that, where someone asked McGregor about him. McGregor was like, "That fucking fat muppet, what's he talking about? He's nearly 50 years of age. He's going around putting his hand in front of his face and saying, 'You can't see me, you can't see me. I can see you, you're right there, you fat fool.'" I was more laughing. That's the first time I heard of John Cena doing this fucking thing. Like,
I've seen John Cena in a few things, and he doesn't look like a man who would have a high IQ as it is.
Yeah?
Get her off the screen.
Oh. Dear Jude, you can't wait to talk about Sinead O'Connor all night. Mikey puts her up then eventually.
No, man, if I can't say what I want to say, then I'm just going to
say whatever
quiet.
You want.
Say what you want.
There's no censorship here.
She's
like,
a goal, man. She actually wrecks my fucking head. She really annoys me. Like,
I disagree.
She's.
I do. Like, I've always liked her. I'm not really even sure why. I've just always liked her.
I think a lot of it was back in the 90s and 80s when she was standing up to the Catholic Church. And
exactly. I loved all
that. That was grand, man. But then as she went on, then she became a Rastafarian. She became a priest of some sort. Now she's a Muslim. I mean, it's a cry for attention. Like,
it probably
pick fucking one of them. Like.
It probably is. Like, do you know? But like, she's been crying for help for a while, man. And she doesn't seem to be getting any help. Do you know? She's put up fucking like suicidal
stuff. Well, I got fucking problems, but you don't see me fucking convert to Islam, like.
But like,
do you know what I mean?
This is
Limerick eyebrows all over again. Like, I'm.
I would say, obviously, she feels like there's something missing in her life. She's trying to fill some kind of a hole. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, I talked to someone.
Don't you dare.
I'll fill her hole. No, you wouldn't.
Oh,
but I talked to someone who changed their religion, and that's exactly what they said, that their whole life they felt like something was missing, and when they found this, they thought that just fulfilled them. Like,
yeah, but I'm sure
she's obviously searching for something.
When she tried to become a Catholic priest, I'm sure she said the same thing.
Did she try to be a priest?
Yeah.
She was a Rastafarian at one stage.
I remember that, yeah. I'll never forget, man. That was one of the funniest things ever.
She was
where she came out on the Late Late Show and she sang a song. And at the end of it, everyone was clapping, and she was like, thank you, thank you. And then she said something about, praise be to the Lord. And everyone was like, ah, the old people clapping. And she went, Jah, Rastafari. And they were all kind of looking at each other and started clapping slower. They were like, what the fuck did she say?
No, but isn't she suffering from mental health as well?
Obviously,
so
like,
if that is helping her mental
health. Who doesn't suffer from it? Like, who doesn't suffer?
Everyone has mental health.
Exactly.
A lot of people can't control it or don't know, understand it.
She always struck me anyway, man, since back in the day, as a highly intelligent person. I always thought she was very intelligent. Like, you know, like, when you watch her in an interview, she seriously knows what she's talking about. But it's one, it's that case of, like, do you know, the problem with really intelligent people is they come across fucking a bit crazy half the times. I think that's what was happening
what
with her. Because, like, she was way ahead of her time with all that shit about, like, remember she ripped up the picture of the Pope and all, and she said the Catholic Church are scumbags, how they treated women and what they did with all, like, we know that's all true, like, do you know what I mean?
She got banned from SNL for that.
Like. Yeah, I think, like,
I think that ruined her career. That,
I think she hadn't performed in America for years after that until McGregor brought her back that time. I think that was the first time she performed in America for years, like.
She changed her name to
David or something.
Yeah.
Shahuda or David or whatever the fuck it is.
Yeah, that's probably some, like, important person's name in Islam or something. That's what they usually do. But, like, I don't know, man. The fucking memes, though, were fairly funny.
She should
to
just
be
admit defeat, David, and fuck off.
Nah, good man. Go, I agree.
Yeah.
Not at all. Thing that makes me laugh, though, is, like, all these people, like, and I've seen it pointed out a few times throughout the week, like, people who are talking about, like, mental health all the time. Post and stuff, oh, it's okay not to be okay, if you need help, I'm here, blah, blah, blah. There's a woman in her mental health is obviously fucked up, and people are doing that and taking a piss out of her all week. Do you know what I mean? Oh, let's all laugh at Sinead O'Connor now. Something's up with her, look, laugh at her, take the piss out of her.
If you don't want people to laugh at you, if you don't want people to laugh at you, don't be posting shit up on the internet for people to look at. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, but if you want to laugh at someone's poor mental health, then don't be fucking posting shit like you're trying to help people with poor mental health. Do you know what I mean? Like, take the piss out of it if you want. I'm not telling people what to do, but, John, don't be too fast about it.
I'll tell you one thing. He's after going all PC on us there.
I'm just saying what I think.
Has he a few whiskeys in that Coke there
That's nothing got to do with politics.
Is the real Eugene there, is he? You ask him to come out?
Yeah, fuck Sinead
O'Connor. What about the Dublin mother I tagged you in yesterday?
I think there's obviously something up with her, like, do you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, of course. She has changed her identity so many times in the last 20 years, you know?
Thanks.
The mad thing about it is,
I love her music anyway.
Yeah, her song, not that song, Nothing Compares to You.
Yeah.
Prince wrote that.
Yeah.
I found that mad. He was trying to sing it himself, but he couldn't pull it off or something, but he got hurt to do it.
Mm.
Something like that, no. I've seen it on the VH1 when they come up and the history of the songs.
Yeah. Her rendition of, what's the tune again? One of fucking
Foggy
McGregor.
Jew.
Yeah, that's fucking classic.
It was a good, version of it, yeah.
She has a version of that out with the Chieftains as well, and it's brilliant.
Yeah, I've heard that, yeah. They did like a live session in a studio thing with it, wasn't it?
She even did one with Roger Walters as well, out of Pink Floyd. They did one of the Pink Floyd songs. It was brilliant as well, yeah.
Yeah, it's a pity, like, I don't know, man, what the fuck happened to her, like. I think, like, it was just, she's seen too many things that bothered her and she wouldn't let it go.
Fame got her, eh?
Because she said even, like, that's why she shaved her head back in the day as well. Because, like, they were treating her different because she was a woman and fellas were, like, more or less like, oh, you know, I can get you in here now if you come for dinner with me and all. And she was like, oh, go fuck yourself. She walked out of there and shaved her head. She was like, I don't want these pricks, like, coming on to me or, you know, treating me differently or whatever. So, I don't know, man. Some people can just let these things go and move on with it.
She was damaged before she got famous.
Who knows, man?
All that came from, I don't know, nobody knows. Who cares? Move on.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, Jude.
Are we done?
What?
Mum finds out daughter has nipple piercing after X-ray. You dirty cunt. What did I tell you about putting metal on your body? I'll bait you. What about the Dublin one I tagged you in yesterday?
What was that?
Centipedes. She was calling them paedophiles.
Oh, yeah.
See that now? Oh, man. All the dirty little paedophiles with the legs. Yeah, I'm not afraid of... No, I'm afraid of spiders, but I'm not afraid of paedophiles. I'll show it to you later on, man. It's fucking brilliant. What are they called, man? Paedophiles.
Yeah. There was a few centipedes after getting into her kitchen or something, or inside in her house anyway, and she was trying to say, like, there's centipedes in the house, but she was calling them paedophiles.
Okay.
And her daughter started recording her or whatever. She's like, the paedophiles. I don't know how they're getting into the house.
Sometimes they're crispy. Sometimes they're fucking dead. What are they called? Paedophiles. Oh, she pure Tala head now. Oh, man, that's what I needed after Sinead O'Connor anyway. Thanks.
Thanks. Thank you yourself. You brought it up.
You're the one Thanks who has the me. Resentment on her.
Oh, what's this now? Dad apologizes after dressing his son up as Hitler for Halloween party.
What's he apologizing for?
Yeah, I don't know.
Wouldn't see Hitler apologizing.
After dressing his son up, look at himself then.
I know, in an SS uniform.
Doesn't he look well in uniform, doesn't he?
He does that, all right.
Did he not see this coming?
Oh.
He dressed his son up as Hitler, and frankly, that's not good enough.
And then the blocks are out. I want to see this for a laugh. I bet it's more funny than the time Joe dressed up as Hitler.
Yeah. Remember the time Joe dressed up as Hitler?
I didn't even dress up as Hitler.
You
I
dressed your face up as Hitler.
I just had a beard one day in Australia, and I said, what will I do to make myself laugh? So I shaved off the beard and I left the little fucking square mustache.
The little Charlie Chaplin.
And you sent the photo to me, man, I swear.
The comb over with the hair was gas.
I was curled up the ball laughing. I thought it was the most funniest thing I ever seen in my life.
Ah, Regin, we don't have the picture here now.
I know.
Oh, but wait, we do. No, we don't.
Do we?
it's on my Facebook now. I can get it up.
Yeah.
Send it to me there, so you know.
Well, I send it to you for the laugh, will I?
No, you won't be able to get it up there, sir. It'll take too much effort.
We'll bring it up next week.
Yeah.
I'll make a note of it.
See if we can offend someone with Jude's
rendition of Hitler.
Anti-Semitic photo, somehow.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's right. That was my profile photo, and then my cover photo was a photograph of a dolphin, but Hitler's head in it, and it says, hey, look, a dolphin. Play on words, you know what I mean? I thought it was comical. He's a bitch, look. It's easy to get him going, look.
It was a good one. Look, we know the man did an awful lot of wrong and all that, but still, he's good for
I'd rather him know to Sinead O'Connor from Bananas.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, man, that's bad.
It's okay for you to turn to National Socialism, but it's not okay for her to turn to Islam. Good story.
It is a good story, yeah.
National Socialism, is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Murdering people, genocide. doing a bit of National Socialism there over the weekend.
He must be in college every fucking week, and he was like, I like that word, I'm going to use that in the podcast now this Sunday.
Looking up all real log ones.
And he was a psycho, God love him.
He was, in fairness to him.
God love him. Why did I say God love him? Fuck him.
The one only good thing is people saying like they'll hate Hitler, he was an evil cunt. But man, at the end of the day, he killed Hitler, like.
Yeah.
You know, he actually killed Hitler. Nobody
did
else.
He though? Do you believe that?
Or did he go to Argentina?
Yeah. I think he did. I think he fucked off to Argentina. I seen a picture. That's all I need. Yeah. I saw a picture of an 85-year-old man in Argentina and they said it was him. I have no reason to disbelieve him.
And I heard a woman who works in a certain place said that there was all hush-hush at that time and they were all in the back room being all sneakily. And I believe it.
The dirty bastards, huh?
Yeah.
Do you know, like, he's a master of disguise, like, he just shaved off his moustache, as if that was enough.
That's the thing, though, like, if he did shave his tash and walked down the road, no one would have known him.
Did you ever see the baby photograph of him?
What? I was actually watching a thing about Freddie Mercury last night, and I saw him without his tash. Completely different person.
Some more of a white man, didn't he?
Yeah, unreal. What a performer, though, man. Jesus. Man. I hadn't seen Freddie Mercury. I hadn't seen any, I didn't even realise, I hadn't seen any of his stuff since I was a child. Mm. He used to always be on telly back in the day when I was a baby, like. Mm. And everyone loved him and all, like, but I hadn't actually seen him on stage performing. There was a documentary on last night. Fuck me, he was unreal, like.
I even still remember the day he died.
Yeah, I remember it as well.
I went was in to you. We were going to school that morning. I called in for you to go to school.
Yeah.
We were only about 7 or 8.
I remember that.
Time.
You were roaring crying. He was like, I don't even want to go to school.
I was trying to get a day off school.
Freddie's dead.
Freddie, yeah.
I was always crying out to school.
I always thought he was born in England as well. He was born in Zanzibar, an island off Tanzania.
Yeah. Exactly, yeah. I just saw that as well.
Yeah.
And it showed him. Then he grew up like in India until he was like 15 or something. Or late teens, actually, it said.
And his father, a military man.
I don't know. Could have been. It showed him then.
Farouk Balsala or something his name is.
Yeah. You have a fucking weird memory, man. How do you remember that? I only looked that up last night and I couldn't even remember it today. Farouk Balsala or something.
I might see the film, though.
Yeah, it looks very good. Your man's a dead ringer.
I heard
Rami Malek.
There he is.
I think we should all go to see it in the cinema because I think if someone was to download it for me illegally, it wouldn't be the same.
No, it wouldn't be, no.
No.
I think it'd be better in the cinema.
Mary, you wouldn't download a pizza. You wouldn't download a car. You know, why would you download it?
No, but genuinely, he even does an opera piece with The Italian one. What's her name?
Yeah. Barcelona is the name of the song, isn't it?
Yeah. Barcelona. Yeah.
And it's live, but it's like they're doing it in the studio.
And he said he was asked as well, would he ever think about doing something with his teeth? But he said, I don't know what this means now, but he said that he had a 4-octave range, obviously something got to do with singing.
Yeah.
And he didn't want to mess it up. So he just left his teeth the way they were, like, and he used to come out, man.
Yeah, I wouldn't blame him, in fairness, man. If you had a voice like that good, you're not going to want to do anything.
He was like that Family Guy character, you know, the English fella.
Yeah, but he was top tooth instead of bottom tooth.
But I watched a thing one night and they were comparing all past singers' voices to this decimal thing on a computer. They could tell how many it got to, and he's got 3 times more than any other singer.
Yeah, he's seriously powerful voice.
Male singer? What? I think I know what you're on about, and I think Barbara Streisand hit the highest.
No, she was under him. He hit the highest. Even though she is a good singer as well. Yeah, like, a bit of Babs.
He was some man to belt out a tune. It's just some presence on stage. Like,
see the fucking live aid he did, and he had like fucking 300,000 people in his hand.
Even the
and he was just like he was just singing random notes in the fucking in his hand. Just singing random notes on stage, and he had everybody copying him.
Even the hair was standing up in the back of my neck.
It was they're a great band, man. Like, that Bohemian Rhapsody was voted the greatest song of all time, like, and it is a great song.
It is, yeah. Very unusual as well. Weird like style of singing,
four genres in one, apparently.
There's no other song really like that. Like, it's so... Yeah. But you know, when they did that song.
When they did that, they told them to cut it, it's too long. And they said, we're not cutting it.
Mm. I think the original is something like 15 minutes or something like that.
Yeah, but it is 6 minutes an odd, because I do listen to
that. That would have been very long back then, especially for a song, like, wouldn't it?
They were saying over it being vinyl at the time. Yeah. They were saying maybe you could do a side A and a side B, but apparently then they said, no, we're not cutting it. It's staying as it is. And now it's voted. It always, when you watch VH1's
what
top 100 best songs, that's always either one or two.
Yeah. That's good tune. He's a lot of good songs, man. You forget about a lot of them as well, like. Mm. Do you know, Under Pressure was a fucking savage song as well, like.
That's the one he sings with David Bowie, isn't it?
And that Even We Will Rock You, like. Was that theirs originally?
Yeah. We will. Yeah.
They invented that whole, like, dun, dun, shh, dun, dun. The whole audience doing it was class, like. Yeah. I was watching last night when he was doing it live on stage. The whole audience was doing the clapping and everything.
It's not that at all. Like, savage. Even Brian May doing on guitar.
Yeah, he was on.
Like, even Who Wants to Live Forever. Did you ever see the video off of that when he's playing the guitar in the middle of the orchestra? And the way they all combine together. It's just class to even look at it.
It is, yeah. There's a big difference between, like, musicians back then compared to what's around today.
The way they have actual real
musicians playing instruments together, like, and like, there's a big difference, like.
And when he was I think he knew about his HIV diagnosis. It was a HIV or AIDS, one of them anyway. But he knew about it for a while. But then when he actually finally came out and made it public, he died the following day from it.
Yeah. Was it, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I knew it was soon. Like, he left it till the end, like.
But you see, if you go back onto the York there, there's an 8-minute video on YouTube. I think it's called The Last Days of Freddie Mercury. Is it there? Go down. But you see him, man, he got pure fucking skinny.
Yeah, his face was all sucked in.
See him there? Stay there. He got pure skinny, man. That was his, I think the name of the song is I Still Love You or something.
Imagine if he was around today and got it today, he'd be still alive.
That's right, because it's controllable.
That's the thing that they said as well.
No, he's not one bit worried
over
advances in medicine.
Well, that's HIV, though. I think if you're full-blown AIDS, you're still fucked.
It starts off at HIV, and then you end up with full-blown AIDS.
Yeah, but see what happened with them as well back then, because there was no treatment for it. A lot of people who, even if they suspected that they might have it, they wouldn't even go and get checked.
They were afraid.
Because they were like, I just don't want to know, like. Do you know?
People are still like that with the likes of cancer and stuff, though. Yeah. And you don't want to be told.
Yeah, I suppose, because, like, they know, like, there's just nothing can be fucking done anyway. So.
When you are told then, man, you get so depressed about it then that it fucking you...
That kills more people than anything, I think.
Because you know, like, you're in that negative state of mind, and that'll bring you down even more. That'll make you worse. Like,
makes you
if
more
you
sick.
Accept it,
you'll deteriorate faster.
The second you accept you're fucked, that's it. Like, you really are fucked.
But even a negative mind fucks you up as it is.
Of course,
never mind a negative mind being told that you haven't long to live.
Yeah.
Look at Sinead O'Connor, convert to Islam.
Jude, let go of that resentment.
That's what I'd be trying to say about these people as well that are online, these haters online the whole time, just talking shit about people. Like we were talking about last time with McGregor or whoever it is or whatever the subject is. People that do that, that is bad for you. Like, you're sitting around all day trying to think of bad shit to say about someone or something. Fucking go and do something else, man. Get out of the house, go for a walk or something. Do you know what I mean? you're filling your brain with negativity all day.
It's like when somebody pisses you off, you blame them, like the reason I'm pissed off is because of you, but yeah. it's not the reason you're pissed off is because the way you look at it, the way exactly, you took it. Yeah. You know what I mean?
It's an inside thing. Nobody has the power to upset you, only yourself.
Only yourself. That's exactly
you know
it.
What
yeah.
I mean? That's what to do.
And it's the sooner you realize that, then the happier you will be.
Yeah, like. But the sooner they realize that it's their own negative self that is making them react to these things.
Exactly. I spent an awful lot of time sussing that out when I was younger, like, do you know what I mean? Because I used to just kind of get pure snappy, like short-tempered, short fuse, like when people say something to me, I used to snap.
Like that as well. I'm still like it now, like.
Hated it. Like.
In my head, I'd be boiling, like, and over something stupid.
I spent
like.
An awful lot of time figuring myself out, like, and these days, couldn't give a flying fuck what anyone has to say about anything, like, do you know what I mean? Like that same, man, offence isn't given, it's taken. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. It's up to you whether you want to take offence to something. Too many people out there are choosing to take offence to fucking everything.
Yeah.
Go find something else to
but
do
they
with your
go
life.
Fighting
seriously,
for things,
like.
But it goes back to what I said a while ago. Yeah, I'm all for equal rights, but I'm all for free speech too.
Hmm.
People have a right to be say what they want.
Exactly, yeah.
Whether you take it on board or you get annoyed by it.
Exactly. Like Bruce Jenner.
Yeah, like if you don't
he'll
like
be a woman
yeah.
and he can ride women if he wants.
Do what he wants. I yeah. just doesn't mean I have to believe it.
Convert to Islam all the like too.
Yeah, just don't do it in front of me.
Yeah, and people have the right to take the piss out of them if they want to.
Exactly.
Do you know?
Exactly.
But like it's the two-faced thing was what annoyed me because I've seen people who are all, it's okay not to be okay, mental health is a serious issue, and then they're taking the piss out of someone with poor mental health. They're like, fuck off, man.
Yeah, but how do you know it's the same people?
Oh, because I know him. I've seen him, like.
See, oh, on Facebook?
Yeah.
All right, yeah, I get you now. No. I understand that, yeah.
Calling these people out.
Oh, who's that? All the private mail me people?
Yeah, PM me, hon.
Yeah, they know who they are.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Oh, dirty, good for nothing, cunt, mate, like that, Joe. Who are you on about, love? DM.
PM me.
PM me. Yeah. No, PM the rest of us because we're all mad to find out.
I'd
now.
Rather eat crumbs with bums than steaks
with snakes. Yeah.
Lost a lot of respect for a lot of people this year. Did you? No one cares. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't care who you lost respect for. Do you know what I mean?
Don't mistake my kindness for weakness. A picture of a lion in the background.
I know, yeah.
You fucking idiot, Joe.
Friends on this with people and then you pass them out in the street, they wouldn't even look at you. Yeah. Who cares?
People giving out, like I posted a thing a while ago and hardly no one liked it. Like, oh man. That's another thing. Like if you're sitting at home watching your last post to see who's liking it and sussing it out,
you're
know what I mean?
Sad bastard.
My God, go do something else, like. Do you know what I mean?
I was going to do that, but then I carried on living.
I'm not even like taking the piss out of people who do that. Like I think that's
yes, you are.
No, but I'm saying like I think that's the thing that you can get sucked into it. Like do you know, and you don't even realize you're doing it. It's like it becomes addictive. Like there are people who are just addicted to social media.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, how many likes did I get on that? Oh, John liked my thing. No, so I'm gonna wait till the next time he likes something. I'm gonna make sure I like his. Yeah. Not gonna like that other bastard's thing because he didn't like mine. Do you know?
Mm.
Like fucking hell, the amount of thought and effort and time that goes into that. You could be doing so many other things with your life.
Tell us more.
Get out.
Tell us more. You know what I say to you, I never thought
it existed. No, if you want to know anything about me, you should know I have a highly analytical mind. Like I analyse the fuck out of everything and everyone. I notice all these little things.
Yeah,
like,
I know you notice
like,
these things, but I never thought you'd get upset over it.
I'm not upset at all.
Not even slightly.
I'm just saying, like, go do something else. You see people doing this and you're like, man, you're wasting too much time on this shit. Like,
yeah.
Go do something else.
I'm half thinking about deleting.
I'm not even saying you're a sad bastard for doing it. I'm saying like it can happen to anyone. Like you can get addicted to stupid shit. Just get out and do something. You're addicted to what?
I'm actually after coming across the fucking the yoke where you can actually delete your account now. Like I couldn't find it for ages.
Where?
On Facebook. And I'm strongly thinking I'm on it 12 years, man, and I'm sick to death of it.
Yeah, you were one of the first ones. The only reason I haven't deleted it is over this. Is sharing this every week.
I fucking like I never post anything on there. I just like. For this and my work, like and shit, you know.
And
what I mean?
UFC.
UFC, yeah. Yeah. That's the only time you're seeing me posting anything. Like, oh man, he had
Put
him.
A vodka, Eugene, up watching.
5 o'clock in the morning. What a fight! Fuck yeah! For doing a full breakdown of the fight. Everything spelled wrong. when he punched him with that dig into the arm and the fucking buzz, referees and audiences.
Yeah, the referees are wanker.
Stop the bus, I want a wee wee.
What are you trying to say, Mikey?
So you used to really grind my gears.
Oh,
yeah.
A lot of women used to post this Marilyn Monroe
If you don't like me at my best,
yeah, exactly that one. Yeah. As if to say, here's a license for me to act like an absolute cunt. Yeah. If you don't like me at my worst, you don't deserve
me at my best. Yeah. You can't handle it.
I only slagged one of the lads the other day.
Have to like you either way, love. Yeah, you know what I mean?
I don't like you either way. So this post is irrelevant to me. So I'm going to move on.
If you feel the need to butt that shit up, then people don't like you anyway.
Yeah.
You drive people out of your lives.
You should see the way I scroll through my Facebook timeline. It's literally like, scroll, 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 scroll. What's that? No, fuck that. Scroll, 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 scroll. Oh, this looks... No, scroll, scroll. Don't care about 99% of it. Like,
Walchie puts something up, or ye puts something funny up, or whatever. That's the only time.
Something funny, like...
All the paedophiles.
I've no interest in seeing a picture of someone's dinner, like...
That's gone, though. I haven't seen that in a while. It's all...
I see it.
I see it myself, but I see it on Snapchat.
Snapchat is gone to now. Thank God I'm not on Snapchat, so...
99% of Instagram is just like, what's people eating for dinner? Where are people now?
Tracking macros, guys, you know, avocado is delicious. Any cunt that says, avocado is delicious, are a lying bastard. Yeah. Vegan or not, it's good for you, but it tastes rancid, man.
I would say there's hardly no real flavour to it. Like,
it's kind of a nutty flavour, but it's like, it's supposed to be a fruit. But it's not nice. I eat avocado, but only for the health benefits, like...
Yeah.
Broccoli is fucking disgusting.
I like broccoli, man. I like sprouts as well.
Yeah. See, anyone who says that they like broccoli is a fucking liar. Cause
I like it, but I hate cauliflower.
Cauliflower, Jesus.
Midget trees.
There's a problem with cauliflower, dude.
No, don't like it.
I'm not really a fan of any vegetables. Like, no, I eat them. Like, I eat like carrots, parsnips, turnip, cabbage, all that. But like, I wouldn't say they're really nice.
Man, cabbage and bacon and cabbage is fucking
small bit of it.
I would take the water and just put it into a cup. I'd put it into one of those little thermoses and bring it to work with me, man. I love it that much.
Wouldn't be a fan of that.
I would be farting like a lunatic after it. You know how much a lunatic farts now? That's
more than a motherfucker. Like,
The lights.
Joe really grinds my gears.
Go on.
When someone says, I don't eat anything green, as if to say, like, everything green tastes the same. It doesn't. Like, what the fuck do you mean by you don't eat anything green?
So you don't eat frogs?
So if you eat a green crayon, like, it tastes completely different to a pea.
A lot of Scottish people I know, like, they don't eat lettuce, they don't eat anything
green. Don't eat green, man. No green for me.
And that's the country with the highest amount of heart attacks.
And apparently the Scottish diet is shocking, all right.
Yeah, would you fucking blame them? Mars bars and batter.
Yeah, battered Mars bears and Iron Brew. Have you seen that fucker, actually? The Angry Scotsman, is it?
Yeah, Scotsman.
Brilliant. He's hilarious. Yeah. He's like, he's inside.
What do you mean you don't have any fucking Iron Brew?
For anyone who hasn't seen it, it's just two friends in a shop or anything like that, and one friend says to the other, they don't have any Iron Brew here. And he's like, yeah, I know. And then he pulls out this little Scottish hat, and he's like, what would the Angry Scotsman think of that? And he's like, oh, shit. So then he has to put on the hat and do the whole fucking...
Right, you bastard. It's him. Yeah, that's him.
Oh, man, he gets into it too. Like,
you don't do Mars and batter. What do you mean you don't do Mars and batter?
You should start doing stuff like that too. Chippers and that'd be raw laughing.
Yeah, he'd be up
right hook, left hook, right hook, left hook.
I'll fight you, you bastard. Yeah.
What's the head? And you know your man as well. Your man that's with him, his name is Kevin Freshwater. Do you ever remember the video? I was out there about 2 or 3 years ago of a fella. He's talking, this is my friend Claudia from South Africa, and I'm trying to teach her some rhyming slang, like apples and pears, stairs, bees and honey, money, but sometimes it doesn't have to rhyme. Like in England, we call cars minge. So you could say, my minge is dirty. It's like, my minge is dirty.
And he's when was the last time you've washed your minge? He's like, I haven't washed my minge for a few weeks. Yeah.
So what's the most people you've had in your minge? He was going, I've had 4 people in my minge at once. And your man starts roaring laughing.
He's like, what the fuck?
That's the same fella, yeah.
Yeah. Gas boys.
What does it mean, car? What does it mean? Vagina. My minge.
Well, did you go out and vote or not?
Oh yeah, Michael D is back on the scene. He is.
Jude likes the D, don't you, Jude?
Oh, of course I do, boy.
I've one question for all of you, right? Michael D Higgins now is re-elected as president. Do any of you actually give a fuck? Like,
not at all. I didn't even go out and vote.
Well, it's only a figurehead.
It's so weird, like, isn't it? Yeah. What kind of a weird?
He didn't even have to do it again, man. After all the money he made on Postman Pat, like.
Yeah.
That was on Facebook.
I've seen it as well. Yeah.
And they're going to call him up for the earnings from that.
His wife is about 1 foot taller than him, no?
Wouldn't be hard, in fairness. Everyone is at least 1 foot taller than him, I'd say. The man, what age is he? He's after being voted in now for another 4 years.
I think he was brought back to life last week or something for the election.
Oh, fuck's sake. animated his corpse. Yeah, I don't know, man.
3D printer.
I honestly just think that we have no use for a president, like. No. Do you know what I mean? He does all, like.
Like, if new legislation is made, he does sign off on that. No legislation can get passed without him signing.
But can he say no and not sign it?
I don't think so.
So what's the fucking point, then?
No, but, like, if it's voted in, it's voted in. Yeah,
and then he just has to sign it. It's a fucking formality. Like, who cares?
We can do without that. I don't care if it's voted in. I'm not signing it.
We could just appoint someone who can sign these things every once a year or whatever and pay him a fucking 50 quid.
I nominate George Joyce anyway.
I'll sign it.
Appoint me as the person who does that and I'll do it for free. I don't care.
Yeah, but I tell you, if
I'm not moving, though, send it out to me.
It's crazy, though, man. Like, he's on like 300 grand a year, is it?
250, but he waived one a few years ago.
No, I just checked a while ago. It was 290 something. It was supposed to be 325 or something like that. And he said, no, I'll take 290 odd.
Nice of him,
in fairness.
Give the rest of the homeless for Russell.
Seriously, like. But that's the thing, though, man. Like, that's 300 grand a year now that's been spent on some fella who basically does fuck all, someone that we don't really need.
Yeah.
And how many houses could they build out of that 300 grand a year? At least three, I'm imagining. Yeah. For, do you know what I mean? It's a bit of an insult, if you ask me, when you have so many children homeless and shit, and then we elect this fella a novelty fucking position and pay him 300 grand a year.
Oh, lads, plus expenses. I'm in a room with two Russells.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah, it is ridiculous, though.
And look how much the British pay for the royal family.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But, yeah, no one's fucking flying over here to see Michael D. Higgins, though. Yes, you know, he's not a tourist attraction or anything like.
Speaking of wankers, what about Bono?
Speaking of wankers.
No, you know, I hate that wanker.
Yeah.
Didn't he turn myself, around and say, someone said to him, you should run for president.
I don't want to
live in a smaller house than my own one, or something like that.
Ah, for fuck's sake.
How long have we gone, Mike?
Don't waste your time, Bono. No one cares.
Keep going, Joe.
What are you worried about, Joe?
Keep her lit.
Have you a hot date?
No, I have a hot date with a fucking garlic bread.
Is your sugar daddy looking for you?
He is, yeah.
Bread.
He's bringing you for a romantic meal,
If you want to be my lover, you got to make garlic bread. Like that one?
Pizza is too easy.
Oh, fucking Yorkshire pudding. What's the Yorkshire pudding?
What's the story with these two boys? Two men hit by used condom falling from Co-op drinks fridge. What? Two boys inside in a fucking Co-op, is it?
Yeah.
Trying to get a drink out of the fridge. Mm-hmm. Got hit by a flying condom.
Fucking hell, that's awful though, isn't it?
Full loading it as well.
Yep, that happens.
Is that in America?
No. Living in America. Fucking condoms everywhere.
No, you get a big claim for that.
America. Is there a Co-op in America? I know there's a Co-op in England, it's not like the Co-op we have here.
No.
Not like a DIY store. It's like a fucking general fucking, like a Coles or something.
Oh, yeah?
Dunn's, yeah.
I have no idea, man. Someone got a belt of a condom anyway. That's all I know. It's kind of funny, like.
He said the 48-year-old reached out and grabbed the Lucozade. Two of them reached out and grabbed the Lucozade at the same time. He must have been sitting on top of one of the bottles. The condom fell on my hand, then it fell on his arm. It must have just bounced.
The boys are at home looking.
Yeah, rubber, like.
It bounced. Bouncy condom.
Would you say no, they're out looking for to claim?
Yeah. I think they probably set the whole thing up.
I know.
Probably went home. One fella put on the condom, the other fella jerked him off.
Goal I hate, man.
There he is, then put something on the end of it.
his father should have put something on the end of it.
They were probably on that Jeremy Kyle show and they told him they were going for a bottle of Lucozade and he told them then to put something on the end of it and they just got it all confused. That's what happened. They tried to put a fucking, oh God, what's this now?
Another one claiming Dr. to
Phil.
Be white.
Oh yeah, black teenager appears on Dr. Phil claiming that she is white. This is another one of these hashtag wrong skin. That's another thing like with them.
I believe her though.
Hashtag wrong skin. Yeah, clearly.
Sorry, mate.
She identifies as white. Like,
do you ever see the meme of Kid Rock? Kid Rock looks like Dr. Phil dressed up as Kid Rock. Do you not see it now?
Kid Rock looks like Dr. Phil
dressed up as Kid Rock.
Why was she denied?
Like Marilyn Manson looks like Nicolas Cage dressed up as Marilyn Manson.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Type in Kid Rock, Dr. Phil.
Kid Rock looks like Dr. Phil.
Like, she was obviously a good-looking girl. Like, why would she deny her race?
I don't know what the fuck is wrong. Probably looking for attention again, like. Oh,
sad,
yeah.
Sad, isn't it?
Jesus.
Do you think her mother would have hugged her as she when she was growing up? Because probably something like that. That's what happens when they
or
don't
she got hugged
their,
too much, one of the other.
There's basic needs every child needs growing up. And one of them is attention, and she didn't get it.
Yeah. This is what happens in a lot of cases, all right? Yeah. these people then, like when they're older, they're constantly seeking attention and, look at me.
They depend on attention then to get by.
Pay attention to me.
Why isn't anybody looking at me?
Yeah, maybe if I say I'm actually white, like even though I'm clearly black.
You have that Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Do you ever read up on that?
No.
Man, a lot of them, like, you have needs in life. Water, food.
Yeah.
All that. Everything else is wants.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Then?
I've always made a big point, you know, and drawn a clear line between needs and wants. Like, do you know what I mean? And don't be getting too stressed out about things that you want. It's like when you have everything you need, you really don't have much reason to be complaining. Like,
exactly. You need to. I need this. That I need. You need to die. You don't need to do anything else. Or I have to have it, and you have to die. You don't have to.
There's only two things you have to do in this life. That's die and live until you die.
Mm. Like food, water, all that. You do need intimacy, all right. Like I will admit, intent comes.
Wouldn't really say you need that now either. You could survive without it. Like
you could, but the body craves it.
Be a bit shit, but yeah.
You know. But even as a child, to be seen, to be heard, they do need that.
Yeah.
You know, when we were kids, we were only seen, we weren't heard. That's why how my Ireland's so fucked up.
I don't think I was even seen. I wasn't around. I was after my own thing. Like.
It's the same, around. Yeah, man. Man, I was only thinking of it the other day. Like, I was like 8, 9 years of age going into town on my own.
Oh, yeah, we were the same. Mm.
Yeah, but my Ross is a lot further from fucking...
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
You were coming into our neck of the woods then.
I was, boy.
We ran that place.
I used to go in with myself and a few other boys. We used to go up to the fucking top floor of Arthur's Key Car Park and throw a lot of toppers down in the street.
We used to do that as well. Yeah.
Do you remember us running you out of it, wasn't
I remember me fucking you off the top floor, all right, Joe.
Oh, yeah.
And then, I remember you fell died. Off, all right. That's what happened, Joe.
Landed on your face. Yeah, it's gas, though. Like, the difference, like, you know, between then and now, like, I think everyone is scared to death of paedophiles.
Has been thinking, like, did my parents really love me? Like?
Yeah, man. I was only having this conversation recently about, like, my father was always a tradesman when he felt like actually going to work or whatever. But like, he always drove a van, like. And like, I've three brothers, myself and my three brothers. If we went anywhere, we were in the back of a van sitting on the ground, just getting flung around the place, side to side. Never mind seatbelt. We didn't even have a seat, like, sitting on the ground or sitting on the inside of the wheel arch. And you need to go over a bump and you slap your head off the ceiling, like, you know? It was fucking madness, like, the ship back then.
You wouldn't get away with it, like, no.
And we used to go to Ballybunion every year, like. And my father would give everyone a lift down to all my brother's friends and probably one or two of my friends. There could be about 12 of us in the back of the van heading down to Ballybunion, like, cool as a breeze.
Not a bother.
Crazy shit. Not one seat or a seatbelt to be seen.
Yeah, but see.
Now it is. It's like,
no,
whoa.
No kids today, if they want to pal with someone, they have to arrange a play.
Yeah. It's madness. Like.
I mean? Garda vitted.
Yeah. Oi, Mikey.
You bang on, no? You know?
It is. It's mad, like.
You do. If you're working, like, training kids in GAA or something, you have to be garda vitted before you do it.
Yeah, yeah. That I understand.
That's fair enough.
But the way you say garda vitted, just hang around with a child, parents are gone that far.
Yeah.
They're talking about microchipping their kids now as well.
Fucking hell, man.
That's already started, like. That's already started. RFID chips. That's part of the Illuminati's big scheme for the New World Order. No, Mikey tells me all this stuff. I don't really know much about it myself.
Well, speaking of Hitler, didn't he predict all this?
Jesus.
We haven't spoken about Hitler in a half an hour, man. Speaking of Hitler.
Speaking of Hitler.
We were talking about Dr. Phil after him.
When you think about it, all his mad rants, if you ever watch his speeches and all that.
They're all in German.
Yeah.
I can speak German.
Right.
You know, und.
Nein, you can't. Go on.
Und I can.
und ja, kann ja.
My name is in a rave. Und.
You're putting on an accent. You're putting on an accent. Like, you're still not speaking German, man. What are you doing?
So I've seen that in Only Fools and Horses. I can speak German. What is your name?
With a V in front of every word.
Yeah. No, but all these mad rants goes on about all that. No, yeah. The banks being controlled by the Jews and. When you think about it, the Rothschilds, they're Jews now, aren't they? And they're part of the Illuminati and all that. And
They're not Jews now, though. I think they were always Jews.
Yeah, but like...
That's the funny thing about that Illuminati shit. Like, when people talk about the Illuminati and people are like, that's bollocks, there's no such thing as the Illuminati. The funny thing is, like, when they say the Illuminati, they are actually talking about real people. Like, those people are there and they exist. Whether they call themselves the Illuminati or not, it really doesn't matter.
But I don't know how true it is, though, but I saw something... on the internet. It probably is false now since it's not on the internet, but it said like the 1% of the world's population owns 98% of the money.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
No, it's not 98, it's 90%, isn't it, or something
like that. I think it was what I heard. So you're going to hear, but depending on what website you want to, you're going to get a different figure. But I heard that 5% of the population owns 95% of the world's wealth.
Yeah.
Either way, there's a massive imbalance there. You know, you have trillionaires and then you have people sleeping in the street. You know, we need to stop them. We need to do something about them. I don't know, man. I'm telling you, what's coming down the line now is AI, artificial intelligence. I'm telling you, this is the one. People are going to merge with technology and only the rich are going to be allowed to do it. So they're going to become a superhuman race and the rest of us are fucked.
No.
Heard it here first. We're not going to be able to afford it.
So we're fucked. Not unless our viewers start sending us donations now.
Yeah. Log on to our website and donate €2 on PayPal.
€2?
donate a rubber mat for the table as well so Russell can stop doing this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But yeah, that's what's going to happen, man.
Democratic process around here. You
need to get a gavel. Slam it down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just about ready to go.
Anything else you wanted to say, no? Anyone else you wanted to...
Khabib and Mayweather, actually.
Oh, yes. That's not going to happen.
Didn't get a chance to slaggy over McGregor. I won't say nothing. I'll just put on this big smiler.
Oh, about him, over him losing. Yeah. I thought you were going to say you were going to slag my...
He might have lost the battle, but he won our hearts.
Yeah. Oh, did he?
He won the money.
How much did he get for that?
He might have lost the fight, but he won the money.
That's one question I had, because you'll know this, because I couldn't be bothered now looking this shit up.
Go on.
What happened to Purse?
He's all right, yeah. McGregor got his money straight away.
What about
they held Khabib's for a while, and then last I heard, I think they released half of it. They're still doing an investigation, so they gave him $1 million out of $2 million or something, and I don't know about the rest of it. I'm sure he'll probably get it anyway. So he might get a fine, but it wouldn't be anything...
But he said it all at one stage. He was like, you can keep my fucking money.
But what we said, that fucking Khabib versus Mayweather. Mayweather's like, yeah, no problem, I'll fight him. But Mayweather will not fight anywhere else but the MGM Grand.
But
in
the
Las
MGM
Vegas,
Grand, yeah.
And Khabib is trying to say, I want to fight him in Russia. Good luck with all that. It's never going to happen. He doesn't get to call the shots anyway. It's up to Mayweather.
If
he's lucky enough, Mayweather will fight him and he'll get the biggest payday ever.
Rocky IV all over again.
He doesn't get
to I'd like to see it happen, yeah. And then I'd like to see McGregor and Khabib go in a boxing match and see who comes out of fucking that.
McGregor murder him in a boxing
match. But this is what I want to see, yeah.
He would murder him in a boxing match. Without the threat of the takedown, Khabib doesn't really have much to he doesn't pose much of a threat to McGregor. Likewise, if Khabib goes in and tries to box with Mayweather, forget about it. In my opinion, Mayweather is the greatest boxer of all time.
He is. Numbers don't lie.
But if you take, fair enough, you have all these other great boxers and blah, blah, blah. But the way I look at it, if you were to take a child and teach him how to box, how can you teach him how to do it better than what Mayweather does? Do you know what I mean? You can't look at Mayweather and say, I want you to be like him, but a little bit better. Better how? He does. Do you know what I mean? You can't do it any better than he does it. So, man is a wizard. He's a fucking genius.
I have a lot more respect for Klitschko there a few weeks ago on League of Their Own. He turned around, they asked him, would he do a rematch with Anthony Joshua? And he said, I would do it for charity.
Yeah?
Yeah. Not a bother. But he said, if I was to go back in the ring, he's retired now, but he said, if I was to go back in the ring, I'll do for charity.
Was he actually on it? Was he Klitschko? I didn't even think he could speak English. He
barely and all that, but he was good in it. I have to give it to him. Even the lads slagging, and it was good. Did you see the one the boys went playing hurling? They were in Kilkenny grounds.
Oh.
DJ Carey was training them. Jamie Redknapp. Freddie Flintoff.
Oh, the lads came over here, was that?
And bust fell at the big teeth, Rob Beckett.
Rob Beckett, yeah.
He's comical, man.
I have a friend that looks like him.
Straight away, Freddie Flintoff picks up the hurley. Boom, boom, not a pattern.
He's always the same, the fucker, isn't he? Just takes everything straight away, and the rest of the lads are like, fuck's sake.
Flintoff, man.
Yeah, he's gas. Did you see when Al Foran pranked him, actually? He rang him up on the radio and pretended he was McGregor. He started taking the piss out of him. Freddie Flintoff didn't know what to say. He was afraid to say anything back because he thought it was really McGregor. That's about it. So, yeah?
Yeah.
That's a wrap.
Yeah.
That's a wrap it up.
Cheers for tuning in, everyone. You're all very attractive.
Yeah.
If you were offended by anything raised in tonight's episode of the podcast, there should be a number on the screen right now for you to call.
Go and buy a box of man-sized tissues.
There should be a number on the screen, but there isn't.
There isn't,
we don't give a fuck. Go find something better to do with yourself.
Instead of a number, do something with
get
that.
Get a life.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Leave it at that. Life.
Outro, Mikey.
Wrap it up, cuz.
Good luck.